sugar pie, honey bunches. Welcome to Monday Night Dance Party, Motown style. I can't help myself. It's Monday and it's time to dance. So welcome. If you're joining us for the replay, you're going to be using the gift of time travel to dance with us. You can still tap and show hearts. You can still share this broadcast with your friends. And those of you coming in live, welcome. I'm so happy that you're here. Oh, yay, Kristen. First comment award. I would love to welcome you all. Please chime in with two things. One, I would love to know if you are new to Monday Night Dance Party or if you're a veteran. And secondly, I'd love to know your first name because sometimes our handles don't reflect our first names. I know, Meredith, I wondered if anybody would actually be on tonight because it's Labor Day. This is our first, like, Monday holiday. Oh, Amy, welcome. I'm so happy you're here. Jillian, good to see you. And I'm Lauren, those who may not know me yet. And I blog over at The Thinking Closet, where I'm on a mission to help you break down the walls that stand between you and your creativity. And this is a part of it. Popsy, aka my father. Yay, veteran. Second time Jamie's back. Girl, I remember you, Michelle's friend. You were so good. I think you got a couple of them in the past with our Name That Tune. And thanks to all of you sharing. I didn't even ask, and you're just spreading the word. Thank you so much. I love this dance party to be as huge as possible because the energy is just electric. Even though it's virtual, I can feel it. And you will too. So if you want to invite your friends, you can just swipe left to right on iOS or up on Android, hit the share button, let people know that they need to stop what they're doing and they need to come here right now and get their dance on. Can't help myself. The Four Tops, people. And I have to say I'm really excited about Motown. Because guess what? This is the first playlist where I had all of the songs already. I didn't have to buy any on iTunes. So I'm a Motown diehard fan. And hello, I love flip-flops. And I'm excited to share my love of Motown with you all. So hooray, oh, Faithy's here. Okay, now let me explain how this whole shebang works for those of you who may be like, who is this crazy woman with the poof and the kind of 1960s outfit on? And I will answer that question. I'm Lauren, and I'm your host for Monday Night Dance Party and Name That Tune. We play a little game, and it's lots of fun. Hey, Mom Who Blogs from Atlanta. And here's how it works. I have curated a playlist of my top five favorite Motown songs. It was really hard to narrow it down to five, but I did it. Very proud of myself. And I'll be playing through that list, five, counting down to one. And your job is to get your dance on, do a little grooving and moving. You can also dance with your finger by tapping your screen, and it makes the little hearts appear. You can even see what color heart you are tonight. It's different every time, but it matches the color of your comments. Fun fact. And whoever I see that guesses the title of the song as it plays first, that's the person who wins that song. And you just win. We give you lots of hearts, virtual hearts. I give you a virtual high five, and it's lots of fun. And I will say sometimes I see a name that's different, or I'll see a title pop up different from what you see. I've figured this out when watching my own replays, like, wait a minute, I thought so-and-so won. So I think it's just a little glitch in Periscope. But whoever I see first, I'll call you out and you'll win. So you have to be thinking of the title of the song so you can name that tune. And then we can do bonus points after that if you can name the group. So we're gonna run through our five top Motown dance songs from the 60s. And then the party really gets started, because we're gonna vote as a group on our favorite of the five. And you can, you get one vote and you're gonna get to pick like which one you love the most, which one you hearted the most. And then whichever one wins is the song we get up on our feet and dance to all together, and you have to do it. It's a requirement, or the Monday Night Dance Party police will find you. Oh, hello from New York Town. Oh, I missed who it was. Greetings from my home state. And so it's lots of fun. But enough chatter. I think it's time to dive in. If you're ready, I want you to type in the word Detroit, which, piece of trivia, Motown comes from Motor Town, which was Detroit, which is where Motown Records was started. Detroit, Amy's ready, Jillian's ready, Kristen's ready, my mom Carolyn is ready, Room with a View is ready. Okay, we have enough people ready to rock. Jamie's ready, Mom Who Blogs is ready, Megan's ready, hey girl. Okay, we got a big enough party that I am feeling the energy, I'm feeling ready to get started. I'm already sweating, how is that possible? Let's dive in to my list. I'm so excited. I really love Motown, if you can't tell. My list of five Motown dance songs from the 60s. Here's the first one. You have to guess the title of this here number. Get ready, set. This is a long title. It took a while. Good job. I love all the hearts. Good job, Megan. Now let's dance. You got it. And name that band. Name that group. I mean, it's pretty obvious. Over the Supremes. Good job. And I mean, what would a Motown mix be without the Supremes represented? So I had to pick one song. It was hard to narrow it down, but this was my one Supremes pick. Good job. It was a team effort. And Diana Ross has made it on our Monday Night Dance Party mixes in the past. She was in the musical The Wiz. I don't know if you remember from our musical theater night, we did Ease On Down the Road. And she was Dorothy in that. I know I mention it every time. If you haven't seen it, see it. It's a little bit of a strange musical, but it's good. Okay, good job, Kristen and Megan with the first one. Okay, that warmed us up. Time to move on to song number four on my playlist, Motown Beats. And another semi-long title, so get ready. Get the hand ready to type as fast as you can. Name this tune and also do what it says. Hint. I didn't even see her come in. Good job, Lizbeth. Good job, Megan. Anyone in Chicago? Shout out. Oh, song number four. You're okay, Jillian. New York City dance. On a street right now. Are you watching Periscope on the street? Good job, Lisa. In my heart, I'm on the streets of New York right now. So come on, every guy, grab a girl everywhere around the world. So I love these Periscope dance parties because they connect us across the world. What 80s movie played this song? Oh, good question. Love that we're creating our own trivia. Anyone know? Yay, good job. Jillian, sorry we couldn't answer the question. I'll be Googling it after this dance party. Good job to my sister. This is the music we grew up with, folks. We didn't listen to pop music when we were in middle school. We listened to oldies. Oh, girls just want to have fun. Oh, I remember that one. All right, friends. If you grew up listening to this music, whether it was retro or you were actually in the 60s, show me some hearts. oldie station, Cool 96.7. That was our favorite. Yes, I see the hearts coming in. If I could do hearts, I would. Oldies all the way. Something about them. Oh, I love it. Look at that beautiful flow of hearts. It's like you guys color coordinated. I love it. Okay, friends. Whew, this is a phantasmic party. We're moving on. If you're just joining us, you're in time for song number 3 on my list of 5 Motown dance songs from the 1960s. We're playing Name That Tune, and we're dancing because it's Monday and we like to get the week started right. So, here is song number 3 on my list. It's a little bit soft. I'll turn up the volume, so listen closely. Get ready to name this tune. No? Good guess. Sister's got it again! And Jamie! Call it a tie! For once in my life, Megan got the full title. Name with this artist. Jamie loves it! Me too! Yes! Stevie Wonder! Don't let sorrow hurt you. It's so golden. You're not alone anymore, friends, because you're with us on Periscope. Monday night dance party. I do too. Here, friends. I'm so glad that you're here to dance with us. Monday night dance party on Periscope. Oh my goodness. Harmonica dance break. Okay. Whew. Okay, gotta rein it in, Lauren. Gotta rein it in. That was so wonderful. I think there are a lot of Stevie Wonder fans in this mix tonight. Am I right? I debated including it because I was like, oh, it's a little bit slow. No. It's a dance song. I'm glad you all agree and loved it. Good job, Jamie and Lisbeth, Megan. All of you win, all the high fives. Okay, we are rolling through the list, rolling right along. And if you're just joining us, welcome. You're among friends here. This is a dance party that we do all together around the world on Periscope. I'm Lauren from thinkingcloset.com, and I'm glad you're here. Song number 2 on my list of 5 Motown dance songs from the 60s. Get ready to name it. Get ready, friends. Ooh, this is gonna make, you're gonna wanna dance. You're not gonna wanna type. You're just gonna wanna dance to this one. You broke my heart. Periscope tonight. Woo! Okay, good job, Jillian, with both the title and the movie reference. Dirty Dancing, starring Jennifer Grey and Patrick Swayze. This is the song that gave the movie the title Dirty Dancing. Okay. Don't worry, this is very clean dancing here tonight on Periscope. And we are at our final song in the countdown. My number one pick of the Motown music of the 60s. Okay, friends, get ready. I love this song so much I might cry. Okay, I'm gonna hold it together, hold it together. Oh, hello! Oh, yes, good to see you, Jill. All right, you're just in time to name the tune of my number one pick, and then don't go anywhere because that's when we get up and dance. So don't worry, if you're just arriving, you're right in time. Name this Motown tune. Oh, Meredith, she was ready. She knew, you knew it was coming. I forgot to remind you, but everyone always pre-types what they think. Meredith, skills. Oh, I love this song. Okay, and I gotta tell you, definitely number one. Okay. That's my sister, Lizbeth. Now, we grew up together. Pause moment. This is why I almost cried, because this song was one that we parodied. Lizbeth, do you remember this, what I'm gonna say? How I wish you were here so we could perform this together. Maybe I can try to perform the parody. Might be a little embarrassing. She knows. Okay, so remember, friends, back in the day when we had voicemail on phone, on our like home machines? I know now we have voicemail just on the cell phones, but back in the day when we had a voicemail recorder, my sister and I would record parodied songs that would play to like make it a little more creative than like leave your message after the tone. And we did, answering machine, thank you. It was an answering machine. All right. And we named that phrase, Lauren can't remember, you all win. And my sister and I did a parody to this song. Let me see if I can remember it. This is how cheesy we were, how we grew up loving the music. Okay. We skipped the first line, so hang in there. We came in on the second, and we did a little duet, like Marvin and Tammy. So we skipped this line. Now imagine you just called our house. Nobody picked up. If you need me, call me, no matter where you are, no matter how far, don't worry, just leave your name and number after the tone, if we don't pick up the phone, cause baby there ain't no message long enough, ain't no message short enough, ain't no message weird enough to keep me from calling you back. Okay, that was it. Oh my goodness, I'm shaking. I was so nervous to sing. But that was our song, our parody song. Oh man, the memories. And you were just a part of that. Those of you who are here. Loved when you did things like that. Miss it. Oh mom, we can still do it. Do it on your cell phone. Thank you friends for reliving that memory with me. That walk down memory lane. Okay. For all the hearts too, I appreciate it. Aww. There's this wonderful moment happening. I'm just feeling all the love. Thank you, best sister, back at ya. Okay, now friends, now that I've sidetracked us, we're coming back on the tracks because here's when it gets really fun. You're gonna vote on my 5 songs from the playlist and you're gonna choose your favorite that we dance to. Oh, help, it's good to see you, friends. All right, now here's how this will work. I'm gonna hold this up and wait till I read through all 5 songs. This is like, I'm your teacher at school. Wait till you've heard all the instructions before recording your answer. So I'm gonna read through the 5. You're gonna think. Which one is my favorite? Hold it in your head. Then when I say go, I'm gonna get my pen and I'm gonna write down all your votes. You get 1 vote, 1 song, so use it well. All right, here we go, friends. In a moment, you're gonna cast your vote. For now, just remember it. Which song do you want to get on your feet and dance to? Is it number 5, Stop in the Name of Love by the Supremes? Is it number 4, Dancing in the Street by Martha Reeves and the Vandellas? Is it number 3, For Once in My Life by Stevie Wonder? Number 2, Do You Love Me Now That I Can Dance by the Contours? Or number 1, Ain't No Mountain High Enough, Marvin Gaye and Tammy Terrell? Okay, think about it. And I'll keep holding this, but you can start casting your votes. I'm ready to record which one, put the number of what you would like to dance to. We have a 1. We have a 3 from Jamie. 1, 4. August says 1, 1, 4, 2, 3, 1, 2. Good, don't worry, Mom, I knew that was a 1. Any others? Another 1. Oh my goodness. A number 2. Oh, sorry, Denise. I know this time is not so great for everyone who's out west. Oh, you can watch the replay and you're just in time to get on your feet and dance. Okay, friends, thank you for voting. And that was I could capture them all. You've perfectly timed it. Number 1 is the winner. Ain't No Mountain High Enough. Marvin Gaye and Tammy Terrell, even though I just sort of played through it twice. You want to hear it again. It makes me so happy. Thank you. Okay, here's how it works. We're going to simply get on our feet and dance. And, oh, Denise, perfect. We chose it for you. Now, of course, I mentioned the Monday Night Dance Party police, but really, there are no police. But in your heart, you will feel guilty if you don't dance. And I don't mean to guilt you into this, but really, it is so good for the soul. On days when I felt like I had nothing left to give, it was a terrible Monday, after I danced, I felt like I could take on the world. There's just something about the body-mind connection and something about great music by Marvin Gaye and Tammy Terrell. So, if you're able to stand on your feet and dance, please, please, please do. Thank you, Mom Who Blogs agrees. And if for some reason you can't get on your feet, then you have to do hearts the whole time, the entire time, as fast as you can, okay? And, or maybe you can do both. Tap and dance on your feet. So feel free to like hold your phone, we can dance together, or you can prop up your iPad or your phone wherever you are, turn up the volume. We're gonna get our dance on, just me and all of you. I know a lot of you love to see my husband Mark join in, and I do too, but he's actually not here tonight, so don't want to get your hopes up that he's going to make like a grand entrance. But he's with us in spirit as he drives back from his camping trip. And I've got all the friends in the world right here on Periscope. So get ready to stand on your feet. Maybe if you have a buddy who can sing a duet with you, do it, whether it's your cat or your imaginary friend. And let's dance to the Motown hit, Ain't No Mountain High Enough. Marvin Gaye, Tammy Terrell, this is for you.
Yeah.
Thanks for the outfit compliments. Whew, a little bit hippie child from Motown, but it was all I had. Had to run with it. Oh, yes, greetings, friends. So happy that you and your daughter are here. I love when it's families dancing together. Nothing will keep me from you. Ain't a mountain high enough. So glad you're all here. Hooray! Thanks for that burst of hearts, too. I felt you with me dancing. Did you dance? Did you really dance? Tell me. Tell me if you danced so I can know who was joining me. I felt I could hear the little foot pitter-patters across the world, and I want to know where they came from. Yes! The health stance, and I believe you, friends. So happy to hear that. You know it! All Ransom sang it! My sister and her new husband adorbs in my bath watching my face go, Denise. Yay, Jamie! Had her little emojis on. Oh, I'm so glad it was fun for you, too. This is a blast. I love this. Okay, now don't go anywhere. Friends, thank you for this flow of hearts, by the way. It really does mean the world to me. I love to give them to people, and I love to receive it. Now, we have several orders of business, more than usual, because first, I'm going to tell you the order we're going to do it in. First, we're going to vote for next Monday night's theme. Second, I'm going to tell you about a fun little giveaway I'm throwing on my blog, free stuff that I want you to have. And three, I'm going to tell you about another scope I have coming up this week. So, one, two, three. Now, Monday night dance parties happen every Monday night, 9 o'clock Eastern, right here on Periscope. If you're not already following me, that's my handle. You can even swipe right now, find me. Make sure to toggle that you're following. It should be blue instead of white. And you're going to vote on this theme. Now, here I've narrowed it down to three. Hear them all before you jump in. Do we want to stick with the 60s and do British Invasion? So think songs like the Beatles. Do we want to go to the 50s, go back an era? I'll bring out my fun little 50s glasses. Or do we want to jump forward in time to the 80s and do power ballads? Even though they're not dancey, we can try to dance to them and there'll be a lot of fun. So tell me right now, do you want British Invasion? Do you want 50s? Do you want power ballads? Okay, power. I think per baklava means power ballads. Autocorrect is crazy on here. Okay, British. That's okay, I gotcha. Another. Oh, Joe wants 80s rock. I'm gonna add that. 50s, British. Okay, we're kind of splitsies. Ooh, another 50s. Power ballads, but a tough choice. Thank you for being honest. Power ballads, another Brits. Okay, looks like power ballads wins it. I don't know what this will be like. Oh, hello, Amanda. Oh my goodness, now the race is picking up for British. Okay, woohoo, and 50s. Okay, we'll stick with power ballads because that was the first one. Don't worry, friends. As Meredith said many weeks ago, there are many Mondays to come. So, get ready to come back next Monday night. Now, that's the first order of business done. Don't go anywhere because now I'm going to tell you about the second order, which is a giveaway. And those of you who may have just joined, I have a blog. And my blog celebrated its third birthday yesterday. So the Thinking Closet turned three. Woohoo! It's my third blogiversary. And I like to celebrate my blogiversaries by thanking you all, my supporters. And I like to throw a little giveaway your way. Oh, thank you, friends. Yay! I've just been blown away by the incredible community of friends I've met through blogging, all of you here on Periscope. Everybody's been insanely supportive of me, and so whenever a blogiversary comes around, I have like a lot of reflection, a lot of gratitude. So I decided to put together a giveaway involving one of my absolute favorite sort of new craft endeavors, and some of you may or may not have heard about it, but there's a movement happening in certain Bibles called journaling Bibles, and this is my journaling Bible. and you can see a lot more pictures of it on the blog. But it comes with like an extra wide margin so that you can do this and paint in your Bible, which might seem crazy to some of you, but this is a really fun kind of new way I've been engaging with scripture. And so I shared just today on thinkingcloset.com my 20 favorite supplies to use in my journaling Bible. And then at the bottom of that post, I'm giving away three journaling Bibles to three winners. So I want you to head over there right after this so you can enter to win. Oh, you are. You just bought one. Okay, well, you can still enter because there's three Bibles I'm giving away, and then the number one prize pack gets like 12 different of my favorite supplies. It's a lot of fun. I had like way too much fun shopping for you all in putting together this giveaway. So, oh, well, it's my joy, and I hope you check it out. Even if it's not something you're into, maybe you know someone else and you could win it for them and give it to them as a gift. So these are sort of hard to come by right now. They're selling like hotcakes on the Amazon. I can only find like two different listings not sold out on Amazon. So I have three in my possession to give to you all. Yay, oh good, I'm so glad. Now, that's item of business, item number two. Go into the giveaway, friends. I want to give you free things, lots of love, at thinkingcloset.com. Here it is spelled out. And if you go to /email, you can join my email list so you can hear all about my Periscopes that are coming up and the ones that already passed. So if you miss any, I repost my Periscopes on YouTube. Oh good, Denise, thanks for sharing that. Barnes & Noble has them. The third order of business is that I am doing a special scope, and it's gonna be going down on Wednesday this week at 4 o'clock Eastern, and I'm gonna actually show you those 20 favorite journaling Bible supplies. So I can answer questions you might have. It'll be a great primer for those of you who might be totally new to this form of art worship, and I'm happy to share what I've learned. I've only been exploring this medium since February, so I'm still fairly new to it, but I've loved it. And there's a great community of people that are diving into this journaling Bible movement as well. And so I hope they join as well and we can have a great conversation. So 4 o'clock Eastern, Wednesday this week. And if you miss it, there's a replay available for 24 hours on Periscope. And then like I said, I'll be uploading it to my YouTube channel, which is The Thinking Closet. And you can watch it there. So that's my updates. To recap, we're gonna meet here again. Same bat time, same bat channel, Monday night for 80s power ballads. Oh my goodness, I might have to get a wig, we'll see. Or maybe I can just go crazy with the hair, pull it off. And then I'll see some of you hopefully on Wednesday at 4 o'clock Eastern. We can talk about my favorite journaling Bible supplies, and you can enter the giveaway right now over at thinkingcloset.com. So, I hope that wasn't TMI. I just wanted to share that with you all. And to take us out, I'm gonna play a favorite song, another one from Motown, by Martha Reeves and the Vandellas, that explains how I'm feeling right now. Heat wave. Aw, you all are wonderful. I'm so glad you came on this holiday Labor Day. I didn't know if I'd be alone. Little saxophone, which I played the tenor sax in high school. Aw, love you guys. Stay cool. Don't get a heat wave.